Hello and welcome to Server Tech Gaming. Today we are playing a little bit of Minecraft 1.10.2. I have the settings working right. I haven't really done too much, as you can see here. I didn't even take inventory yet. I'm just mainly getting stuff set up so I can make sure stuff's running good. Before I set up this new computer, I did have problems playing this. If it is really frame laggy for you and you still want to play the game but can't really play it, go into your settings and turn the mipmaps all the way down to zero. Or turn them off, don't have them on, and you should be able to play the pack after that. It made it playable for me, but I just recently upgraded my computer and I'm playing with everything fully on. You probably hear my little butthead bird in the background. He's a trip. His name is Curtis. Every now and then I might actually have him out. He's actually mad that I don't have him out right now. He likes to sometimes copy games when I'm playing too. It's hilarious. We're gonna pretty much do this as kind of a let's play. I'll explain some of the stuff and how I do it, but really we're just gonna kick back and play and see where this one goes. I got my computer built and upgraded. I'm going to be building quite a few rack mount servers here to host various games. And when I do, for the one subscribed to my channel, we'll get access to some of the servers. Couple of the channels I will, or channels, a couple of the games that I do have will be pay to join, just because of the cost of the hosting of them to get the server packs for them. It's not Minecraft. A couple of the other games, the server packs are very expensive to get, so at least I will have to charge. Or I shouldn't really say months, it'd be more the first certain amount of people I will have to charge until that money's recovered, and then I wouldn't have to charge no more. A lot of games I like doing my own hosting because I'm not stuck with whatever settings the host service decides to have, which sometimes that can be a real big nuisance, having to follow their rules and regulations, and you can have this pack but you can't add this mod because it's not officially supported or stuff like that. Actually working out a contract right now with a couple MMOs because of the quality of my internet. to that sign on and maybe host a couple of MMO servers out of my basement here. Hole for the night and dig in and make a few things here. Yeah, I know it's real dark, you can't see, but that's the way the cookie crumbles, I guess. Need to upgrade my mouse. My mouse button is a little messed up. It likes to stick on me. There it is. So let's put this here so they can't climb over that. We can go back in our corner and continue building stuff. Really, the only thing I need right this second. No, we don't want that right now. We need one more of those. Those. Is a pickaxe. That's the main thing we need right now. So dark, I can't see nothing. So I can turn brightness up in here a little bit too. There we go. Bit of stone so we can build our basic tools for now. I won't be cheating items in, but you will probably between the episodes see me having stuff that I'd didn't have the episode before. That's because I will do my mining off screen unless we really don't have anything planned out for that day, and then if I see something I need, I'll just go ahead and pick it up. Here. Okay, we've got some sticks, we've got a sword. Should probably build an axe. get the shovel. Daytime. Okay, we'll come back down here and grab a little more stone then. Oh, looky there. That was the next thing I was going to look for. Oh man, I'm tired today. Had a long week this week. Work and getting this new computer up and running. I went from a 15-year-old processor to a FX 9590 AMD to the Corsair Formula 5. Board with 32 gigabytes DDR3 G-scale memory. And I had 8 gigabytes before. So going from 2.3 to 5 gigahertz, yeah, I took a heck of a jump. First I wasn't going to, and then I was just like, whatever, let's just make the jump, go ahead and do it, and I'm thankful I did now. That torch is not what we really needed right now, but okay, whatever. I got a mob trap. I've actually been wondering how I was going to build a mob trap in 1.10, because they don't just jump out into everything like they did before, so kind of interesting before. We actually, I think we can shift with these. Nope. Not with this anyways. We shift click with the tool, yeah. If you shift click with a tool, you can get that. It's very handy to have, because when we find our home, we can actually grow that. So let's throw all this stuff out. Keep the rest of that. I actually didn't want to pick the stuff up. I'm gonna go over here. We shift. Click. Got it. The reason you collect these is because they do just randomly grow. So you can put them around your base and be able to get some extra food from and stuff. It's very handy starting out. It's from Pam's Harvest Craft. A nice little space, not that far from home. Looks like we got a dungeon, or not dungeon, but a runic place over there. This probably won't be a bad little place to build, actually, over here. A little water right here to start out with. So it looks like a little cave system over there. We do have more of these bushes. This is a different kind, so I will come get it real quick. And what's this? Spruce wood, maple wood. Get what the difference of that was, but okay. What we got up here? Not much. Yes, I am going to kill your kind because I need wool here. So rice seeds, coffee seeds, so we'll throw the beans out for now, throw the rice out for now. We don't need this stuff. Let's throw the rice out. We got what we need here, so let's go ahead and keep on our way. Ouch. Oh, we got guardians. Out this area over here real quick before I decide I'm gonna set up here. It looks like we got a lot of guardians around here. Canola, but where'd the seeds go? I must have thrown the seeds out. Okay. What do we say? We got a nice little area right here. With the pond. We can build out this way. Some chests. That was wool. Put this in there. Put seeds in there. Put these in with seeds since that's growing stuff. For now, I guess we could put trees and flowers in there too. And let's do one more of these to get another set of chests. This will just be the miscellaneous stuff, but I actually don't need that in there. I need this stuff in there because those can go in there. We will actually take these out. We'll put this stuff in here. For flowers. Or, yeah, that's Botania, so. So let's stay a little organized. We'll put, so need one of you. One of you can go in there. And one of you can. The rest of the stuff we'll plant. Okay, this is gonna slow progress down, so let's go over here. Need wood. I'm gonna need in here. Plant and cobble. I think we make a stick and put a stick here and put. Oh, how's that made? I don't remember. Oh, okay. It's changed a little bit. Here we go. This will just clear everything out a little quicker. Fill that area out a little bit. It's nice, especially now with the run on 1.10, to have the grass cleared out there, because if you have to kill anything, it takes priority over hitting grass than it does mobs. Which sometimes can be pretty bad. It'll make you die a few times, be pretty frustrating. Dark again already, aren't it? I should do this as an internal day kind of thing. That way we wouldn't have to worry too much about this. Darn it, I didn't want to hit that, but okay. Let's hope we got an Ender Lily seed. Look, we already got a visitor. Ouch. Ouch. Eventually, once I get a house made, we won't worry too much about lighting. But right this second, it's going to help us survive. Probably not as much right now since I was a little slow at putting them up. This will stop new stuff from spawning. And I'm dead. You. I didn't want to have to dig that sand up. Died on the first night. Imagine that. Usually don't happen that often, but since I was sitting here collecting too much stuff and not building a house as I traditionally do out of dirt first, look at all the zombies. Oh, look, there's a bunch of skeletons too. Ouch, ouch. Run, ouch, run, ouch. Ouch. Fight for me, my little friends. I won't slay you, cows, if you help me. What I was doing just then when I died, I was trying to dig into the wall. If you dig into the wall and then dig up, it'll give you an air pocket to breathe out of, usually. So, but my dumbiness, I done that. And I hear spiders. I hear spiders. Save me. Did he give up? Nope, he's still in pursuit. Dun da da. Chicken. There, I saved you. Grrr. Okay, we got our stuff back and got that, so let's get back over here to the lighted area. There we go. Now, get in here, we're gonna need some wood. Let's go ahead and place that, 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 and that. And we got a bed. And now that we've done that, established a little place where we're going to start setting up our base, I think. Now would be a good time to call episode one quits. Thank you guys for watching Silvertech Gaming, and I will catch you back in the next one.